Thank you guys for coming to the Lexington. Well, actually, it's called the Ghost Walk of Lexington. I really do appreciate y'all coming. My name is Patty Starr, and I am a genuine certified ghost hunter. And I've been ghost hunting over 40 years. And I've ghost hunted in 3 different countries in 26 different states in the United States. Now, that's not to impress you, but just to impress upon you, hopefully, all the experience and evidence and things like that that I've been blessed to have documented on these ghost investigations that I've been on. At one time I used to do college tours, and on the college tours, after the lecture, we got to have a lottery, and we would take 40 students into an area of the college that was haunted, and we would do a ghost investigation. So that gave me a lot of experience and research that I've been blessed with. I just thought it would be a lot of fun if I could share with people the experience that I've had with ghosts, and the only way I could do that was to use equipment such as photography, film, audio. And so that's what got me started, basically, is because I wanted other people to have a little bit of an experience of what I was going through. Right around 1999, I think it was, I went to LCC, which at the time was Lexington Community College, and I went to a dancing program that they had. I wanted to learn ballroom dancing. And I happened to wear one of my t-shirts, you know, ghosthunter.com, and the instructor introduced me to one of the administrators, and she said to me, "I think this would be a great subject. Would you consider teaching this at our college?" And I was like, "Oh my gosh, yes." And so in 2000, I started teaching ghost hunting at LCC, and it was very successful. And then they asked me if I would teach like an advanced course. So I taught the intro to ghost hunting and the advanced course of ghost hunting. Well, in 1995, I moved to Bardstown, Kentucky. And I was already an established ghost hunter when I moved there. And so shortly after I had found my place to stay, and I went into the downtown area, and oh my goodness gracious, the energy there was just phenomenal. And I could hear and feel and see ghosts everywhere. So I walked into the Talbot Tavern, and the energy that I felt there, I thought, this is where I'm going to have to get a job. And I did. I became the general manager of the Talbot Tavern. And I was there until 1999. In the meantime, I got the best lessons about ghosts. I even tell people, I've learned more about life from the dead than I have the living. I got really ingrained in the history, and from the history, I started connecting some of these spirits. Then the Chamber of Commerce came to me and said, "Would you consider doing ghost hunt, a ghost walk here, you know, because you're a ghost hunter and maybe you could put together a ghost walk?" And I said, "Oh, I would love to." So in 1997, Bardstown Ghost Trek was founded. And so I'm in my 21st year. And we have a lot of really good success. Our biggest success is when Jesse James comes through for us. I think around 6 years ago, there was a lady on the walk. And I had brought in a few pieces of equipment, and we were up in one of the ballrooms at the old Talbot Tavern. And I asked in my recorder if Jesse James was going to join us. And we got this wonderful EVP, and it said, "You bet." And so people were just taking pictures, some of me, and I'm walking around telling stories. And this one lady took a picture of the fireplace, and she kind of squealed. And we all ran over to see what she had in her camera. And it was this full apparition of a man standing in front of the fireplace with a white cowboy hat on. So we really did feel like at that moment in time that we got the apparition of Jesse James. And so I loved telling the story, of course, on my ghost walks until last year. Last year, a lady had decided to check out my website, and she saw where I had got a picture of Jesse James standing in front of the fireplace. So she came into the tavern, went upstairs, found the room, And it was in the middle of the day. It was around 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon. She goes over to the fireplace. She says, "Jesse, will you appear for me?" And she took a picture. She got Jesse in front of the fireplace with a white cowboy hat on. And so I thought, oh my gosh, after 6 years, he's still willing to come through so that we can see his shape and form, letting us know that he still loves to come to the tavern. So when I moved to Lexington, Kentucky, the Bardstown Tourist Commission contacted me and said, "You are still going to do the Bardstown Ghost Trek, right?" And I was like, "No, I live in Lexington now, and that's about 1 hour and 10 minutes away." And they just kept on and on, and so finally I did agree to continue to do the Bardstown Ghost Trek. So it didn't leave me much time to have another ghost walk in Lexington. But then after 2016, when my husband became disabled, we then sold the Ghost Hunter Shop and the Scarefest and my Mystical Fair. And then that's when I thought, this is the time for me to take the opportunity to have a Lexington Ghost Walk. So in 2017 was the first Lexington Ghost Walk. And I'm really excited about it because our evidence is growing a lot faster than the evidence that I used to get in Bardstown. In 2001, I opened up the first brick and mortar ghost, I called it my ghost hunter shop. And it was all about instruments. And then I found a retail, well, I guess he was a wholesale person that started selling me the meters. So when I first opened, it was mostly selling my dowsing rods and then the meters. And then I realized that people needed books to learn how to ghost hunt. So I wrote my first book in 2001, I think it was. It was called Ghost Hunting in Kentucky and Beyond. And then in 2010, I wrote the second book, which is similar to the same title, but it was part of a American Haunted Road Trip series. And the company assigned an author per state to write books, and it would be like Ghost Hunting Kentucky or Ghost Hunting New Jersey or Ghost Hunting South Carolina. And I was the one that was asked to do the Ghost Hunting Kentucky. But these books I was able to also put into my ghost hunter shop. So I had the first brick and mortar ghost hunter shop, and then I started bringing in more books and equipment and vests and t-shirts, and it got pretty big and pretty popular. And again, that was, I had that shop until 2016. Right around 2005, I had a former student come to me and say to me, "Patty, how about us getting together and doing a HARTA convention?" And I'm like, "All right, I know I'm a ghost hunter, all right? But I am not into the horror. I'm not into the dark, the exorcism, the evil. I just don't want to do that. But you know, if I could bring the paranormal side into the convention, then I would be interested in doing that." And that's exactly what we did. We had the first horror and paranormal convention in the USA. And we actually planned it for over 2 years. And so we made a commitment. We went to the Lexington Center, we got Heritage Hall, rented it, and in 2008 we had our first Scarefest. And we were very successful, and it grew very fast. And then in 2016, my husband became disabled, and I decided that I would go ahead and we would sell our Scarefest to an awesome couple, Brandon and Nicole Griffith, and they are now working with that, and they're going to make it even bigger and better.